Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave Mazda. Dave is the head of product and managing director at Direxion.com. As you're over to our website at TFNN, just hit that Direxion banner. We'll bring you over to their website. Dave Mazda, how you doing?
Doing well. Happy to be here.
And we have a market, Dave. We have a two-way market. Now, you know, we've been on the air for years, and it seems like the last 3 years we've had a one-way market. So it's pretty cool whether we're looking at small caps, whether we're looking at the banks, whether we're looking at the biotechs. And when you're doing this, folks, that, you know, the small caps, you have the TNA, the TZA, you know, the banks, you have the FAZ. You know, let's start, Dave, with the small caps, because it's so intriguing. The small caps, they don't move and until they move, and then they move like beyond belief, man.
Yeah, I think it's really interesting. So you noted TNA, TZA. In the last week or so, we've seen on multiple days some of the highest ever trading volume in those bull and bear funds, which to your point in the intro here, maybe be expected. What I find interesting about small caps as an investment, and then especially the trade, they've been range bound for most of 2021. All strategists, if we were sitting here a year ago saying, it's going to be here for small caps, market cycle, blah, 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 if you will. And guess what? They ripped and they did nothing until about November and they broke out. And what and many people are saying, well, again, here's what we've been waiting for. Then they come crashing down on the Omicron variant fears. And here we are again with this really fat trading range. So I think to your point, two-way opportunity to really on a daily basis be looking at small caps.
And what's so cool, folks, is this. As Dave is explaining, you got a consolidation, okay? Now, the bottom of this consolidation, I'm talking the TNA now, okay? So the TNA is trading at 81. It's up $5.50. What's so cool about this, particularly as a trader, is that you can put your stop so close right now, folks, okay? So it's something to keep your eye on. And, you know, I love consolidations. Well, consolidations drive us all crazy, Dave, but when you get to the bottom or the top one, it's kind of nice when you're looking at a trade, because the reality is that, you know, you don't have to risk a huge amount in order to basically maybe make some money, you know. So let's talk banks. OK, this, you know, you heard me at the beginning. I mean, it's hard to comprehend even when I say that. OK, well, I know that the note and bond market, the TLT, where they went up last week with volume. It's like, who would ever think, like a year ago, we were supposed to go up in rates, and yet we're trading, I think it's 140 right now on the 10. Yeah, it's 143 on the 10.
Yeah. The backdrop for banks just got a lot more interesting for a couple of reasons. One, to your point, we were kind of on a nice march higher on the 10-year.
Yes.
And people were getting excited about how that's going to help financials, steepening yield curve. Well, guess what we saw in the last week? Yield curve really flattening. Not saying that's going to be the case, you know, but I think we're around 80 on the twos, tens right now. That's actually not a great environment for banks. But guess what? Today, most banks are ripping just because the general, some fear is coming out of the market. What I do think much of this, again, is opportunity for traders to really look at the FAS and FAZ as noted before. But again, it's really unclear, unless you want to make a fundamental bet, that the Fed is going to continue to go on the path that now they're saying. Until December 15th, until that FOMC meeting, we're going to see a lot of volatility, especially in the rates market. And what that's going to do is really make, you know, I think maybe on a daily basis, financials be up, you know, the best performing sector, and then maybe the worst performing sector conversely.
Yeah. And we got to go over to the gold market, folks. OK, so inside the gold market, this is one of the first days. Now, you talk about one of the largest caps that have not caught a bid, and that was Newmont. Newmont, folks, has been down for 6 months. Bottom line, you know, last Thursday we hit 52.87, and we just might get some action. And if you're looking at the, you know, the gold market, the gold equities, you want to look at NUGT. What's so wild, Dave, is that, you know, Newmont, you know, I've got plenty of calls in here, and so it's really because of Newmont and, you know, Barrick having such a large weighting. You know, Newmont's bringing this down for quite some time, but it was interesting this morning, Newmont finally caught a bid. So the real question is going to be like, okay, we're going to get some action here because they, you know, they're a large weighting structure inside of this gold market.
Yeah, so I think you raise a really good point, especially about gold miners and then a few other sectors, which is probably a conversation for another day. Is, you know, these are amplified exposures. You're talking about nugget dust. It's, you know,
yes.
Either three times or two times. But at the end of the day, the driver of that performance, and maybe this sounds silly, is the stocks that are in the index.
Right.
And when you have stocks like that representing such large weights, and one in particular dragging down the overall performance, it was difficult to see that breakout. That's changed a bit potentially. So now I think we're probably going to see interest come back into the miner space, because from a volume perspective, in the last couple of weeks, it really was the two areas we spoke before. Of course, always the S&Ps with SPXL and SPXX, small caps saw a big increase in volume. And then, of course, the semi and biotech space. But I've been watching the miners as well.
Well, I like the idea that there hasn't been volume there. That's good. That's what a bottom takes, folks, okay? Dave, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to having you on 2 weeks from today.
Talk soon.
Thank you, man. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.